Wendy, darling, you don't look very happy. What's the matter?
Jules, when you said we were going to be crafty beggars, this isn't what I had in mind.
Look! Thank you, they've given us some amazing buttons.
Wow, things are looking up.
Crafty Beggars is brought to you by Hobbycraft.
Hello and welcome to Crafty Beggars, the show that puts the competition into crafts.
Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside, and where better therefore than here in Brighton. But rest assured, there will be no time for sunbathing.
Certainly not, as our two teams have just a few hours and a tiny budget to buy, borrow and beg all they need to make a range of handmade crafts.
And they're going to have to work super fast to gather all those goodies together to sell in Brighton tomorrow.
Our four crafters are raring to go head to head.
So let's meet them, today's brilliant crafty beggars.
Lucinda Colegate is studying to be an architect. She's a self-confessed hoarder and loves to upcycle furniture. Jade Turner studied fine art and is a talented mixed media artist. That means she works with lots of different materials.
Thea Wilkins and Suki Price are freelance illustrators. They also enjoy painting murals. They run their own business and would love to open their own shop. Perfect for passionate crafters.
So girls, what are you going to be making?
Well, we want to keep in the theme of Brighton and we want to do mixed media sewings and canvases, something similar to this.
Great.
Keeping it really simplistic.
Uh-huh.
And we'll be working with postcards.
So Suki and Thea, the big question girls, what are you going to make today?
We're going to be doing upcycled bottle cap jewellery.
Right, sounds so interesting.
Adding charms and whatnot and glitter, making some badges and maybe some magnets, and we're going to maybe do a magnet board as well.
Nice.
Brilliant, this looks like a good pub for a beer, I mean bottle tops.
Yeah, obviously. I have a quick one, we're in there though.
That's nice.
Yeah.
We could do something with this.
Yeah, we could use that for maybe like the pier bit.
Yeah, no, that's really nice. I think I'd wear that.
Well, our two teams have worked really hard this morning. But I tell you what, there's no time for rest or relaxation on this show.
Absolutely not. Well, it's different for us, obviously.
Oh, yeah, well, I mean, it's different for us. But for our contestants, well, it's now that the real hard work begins.
Yes, our crafty beggars have only got until tomorrow to make a range of handcrafted items good enough to sell. More candy floss, Wend?
Cool, don't mind if I do.
Stick a rock?
Oh, yeah.
Whilst our teams get to grips with the task ahead, we check out two crafting experts.
40 years ago, dare I say, I was taught to needlepoint by Nanette Newman. A very creative, artistic, clever lady. She taught me all you need is a bit of canvas, a needle, and a basket of wool.
I was a designer of gift wrap in the 1960s, but the problem for me is gift wrap torn apart, thrown in the bin. Awful. I thought, ah, I will reproduce them as needlepoint. And so I did.
They make fabulous cushions. And of course it means they'll last.
That's the point.
Basically the aim is to use mixed media.
Yep.
To layer up the iconic images of Brighton.
Okay.
Well, I think you're cracking on really well. And I love these earrings here you've made.
All we had to do was find the right photograph and then stick the shiny dot over the top.
Jade and Lucinda continued mixing their media as the night fell.
And Thea and Suki burned the midnight oil with their bottle tops.
Well, they say tomorrow never comes, but for our four crafty beggars, here it is. Our two teams are busy setting up their stalls, making them look as attractive as possible to entice lots of customers.
But whose handmade crafts will make the most cash? Let the battle begin to see who will be the victorious crafty beggars. It's like glue guns at dawn.
Don't tempt fate. They could all come to a sticky end.
Sorry.
Crafty Beggars is brought to you by Hobbycraft.